So Timo Boll has lost to Jong Yong-sik in the round of 16 in the men's singles Olympic event. And that means that for the sixth time, Timo is not able to fulfill his dream of getting a medal in the Olympic Games singles event. And I've seen many of Timo Boll fans being really surprised and upset with this result, but it was no such a surprise, as I will try to explain you in this video. Already before the match, already from the matchup, you could tell that Jong Yong-sik is like made to make Timo problems. Just look at their match history. They've already played about four times, and once Jong could already beat Timo Boll, and once he had match points against Timo Boll, and also in the last encounter it was really close game, but at that time Timo could steal the victory for himself. But how is it so that Jong Yong-sik is so good against Timo Boll? To get a good answer to this question, we have to take a look how Jong Yong-sik plays, what is his game style, and where are his strengths, and what that all means for Timo Boll. So first thing that we have to take in account is that Jong Yong-sik is very safe in his game. He can block a lot of shots, and that means for Timo that he has to play a lot of rallies, he has to stay near the table, and that Timo has to be really aggressive. And when you think about that, you will find out that Timo is not really known for playing aggressive. So this is the first area of the game where Timo has to play in a such a way where he is not so comfortable playing. And this close to the table blocking style is something what Timo doesn't really like. And you could see that also in the past, as Timo had problems with similar players like Jong Is. For example, Adrian Crisan or Oh Sang-eun. These were also the players who could beat Timo Boll. Secondly, when we take both diagonals, where just the majority of the shots are played, we will find out that Jong Yong-sik is strong where Timo is strong. That means this forehand to backhand diagonal from Timo, and that Jong Yong-sik has a little weakness in his forehand side, but in this backhand to forehand diagonal, Timo is not so comfortable playing, as he now at the age of 40 is not really able to run around his backhand and play forehand there. He is not anymore so quick to pivot his backhand there, and that means he has to stay there with his backhand and play aggressive with his backhand. So now let's take a look at their last encounter and see a little bit closer how Timo dealt with these areas of the game against Jong Yong-sik. So in these points you can see that at that time Timo was really able to stay near the table and be aggressive. And look closely how Timo attacks forehand side of Jong's to get real advantage in these points. focus also on how Timo is able to be aggressive with his backhand. How can he prepare the winning shots with his backhand? That's real class from Timo Boll in this match. And also focus on how Timo was winning service receive game. When receiving, Timo could well spot when service was going long and attack immediately with his forehand topspin. And in Timo's service game, he could really nullify the Jong's banana flick, as he used a lot of long services, or he placed the serve extremely to the forehand side, or on the other hand to the backhand side, where is not so many space to attack with banana flick. And now take a look at what happened in their Olympic encounter. In the early stages of the game, Timo tried to use his normal tactics, that means attacking middle and backhand side of his opponent, but this was a little bit naive tactics, while Timo was playing to Jong's strengths. And Jong responded well to these tactics. He was attacking with his backhand and covering table well, and he was attacking Timo's forehand wide corner. After that, in the second game, Timo started to do what he needed to do. That means attacking with his backhand and being aggressive near the table. But unfortunately for Timo, he couldn't play these tactics repeatedly. He was making some misses on the way, and that meant that he was not able to win this key area of the match. And as Timo started to lose some confidence, he did what he always does when he is not confident enough. That means he backs off the table to have more time for his shots, but this was just giving advantage to Jong's game plan. You could see that Timo was under pressure, because he was also during the game making some errors he normally doesn't do. And all of this resulted to the key moment in the fourth game, where Timo was leading 9-7 and had two serves. He played a reversed serve to the forehand, where Jong played his banana flick and Timo missed his backhand attack. And as the result of that, in the next point, where Jong once again attacked Timo's backhand with backhand banana flick, Timo didn't trust his backhand enough to play it, and he pivoted his backhand to play forehand there, but he was late to the ball. He just had to spin the ball on the table, and from there Jong got the opportunity to attack in this rally, and that's exactly what he did, and he won the point. And the last point where Timo truly lost the match was 9-all point, where Timo actually played this point really well and got good opportunity to attack with his forehand, but he was just too tense, he was just too nervous, he rushed his attack with his forehand and missed it. After that, Timo misread the serve of Jong and played a bad receive, and Jong took the fourth game. And in the last game, Timo just lost his patience, he tried to be over aggressive, he overhit it a lot from his forehand side, and that resulted to great victory for Jong Kyung-sik. So that's it for this timeout, for this game analysis. In case you enjoyed the video, please share it and like it and leave us a comment down below. Thank you and see you soon.